So let us talk about evolutionary stable strategy in little detail. What we have now, let us say that there are two types. One is incumbent type, which was present earlier, and now there is also a new type, mutant type, in the population. ESS, or evolutionary stable strategy, is a strategy that cannot be invaded by a mutant population. What do we mean by invasion? That would become clear. If an animal, if a particular characteristics has is evolutionary stable, what it means that animals having this particular characteristics with will have higher fitness in comparison to of the same kind of animal with different characteristics. So if the animal will have higher fitness, they will have higher reproductive success and they would sustain in the population. What can we do here in this size game? We can say that each beetle is repeatedly and randomly paired off with other beetles, because we want to know average fitness. So average fitness would be determined over longer period of time, through which, because a beetle would interact with different kind of beetles. Okay, invasion would become clear soon. Now what we say, strategy T invades a strategy S at level X if X fraction of population uses T and 1 minus X fraction of population uses S. What we mean, let us say that beetle world is entirely made of small beetles. Of course, my poor picture, but okay. And this is the entire population, and now let us say X fraction of large beetles are introduced. That's what we are saying, that here strategy S is, we can say, small, and here we say strategy T is large. So strategy large invades a strategy S at level X if among the whole population 1 minus X fraction of population uses S, that is small, and X fraction of population uses T. Okay, so formal definition, strategy S is evolutionary stable if there is some number Y. This number Y is not very important, it just says that there exists some X which is greater than 0. Okay, and when any other strategy T invades S at any level X which is less than Y, the fitness of an S is strictly greater than the fitness of an organism playing T. Let us understand it little bit. What's happening here? We have already talked about the invasion. Now what happens, that if average fitness of a small beetle is higher than the average fitness of large beetle, then on average small beetle would have higher reproductive success, their proportion in the population would increase. It also means that the proportion of population of large beetle would decrease. X is anyway small, and eventually it will become equal to 0. So over the period, small beetle would be able to withstand an invasion of large beetle. Okay? If a strategy is able to withstand such invasion, then that strategy is called evolutionary stable strategy. Okay, now let us do it mathematically. In this particular size game, can we call small an evolutionary stable strategy? Let us check. What we say, that small is already present and large is invading. So after the invasion, large is with proportion X and small is with proportion 1 minus X. When can we call that small is evolutionary stable? When on average, in this new environment, new, what is the new environment? That small beetles are of proportion 1 minus X and large beetles are of proportion X. In this new environment, if a small beetle does better than large beetle, then of course small would be evolutionary stable. But if in this changed environment, if large does better than small, then we cannot say small is a evolutionary stable strategy. So, this is what we have to check. So, again repeating the same thing, 1 minus x and x, what would be the expected payoff of a small beetle? Let us say in any interaction, if small beetle is interacting with any other beetle, what is the probability that other beetle is also small? 1 minus x, because 1 minus x proportion of the beetles are small. So, that beetle would obtain 6 with probability 1 minus 6 and 1 with probability x. So, what would be the expected value on average? What we can say that a small beetle would obtain 6 multiplied by 1 minus x plus 1 x. So, it would be 6 minus 5 x. What would be the expected payoff to a large beetle in this new changed environment? With probability 1 minus x, a large beetle would meet another small beetle. In that case, payoff is 10 for the large beetle. And with probability x, this large beetle would again meet a large beetle. So, in that case, payoff is 4. So, how much is the expected payoff? 10 multiplied by 1 minus x, 4 plus 4 multiplied by x. So, we get 10 minus 6 x. Okay. So, expected fitness of a large beetle in this environment is 10 minus 6 and expected fitness of a small beetle is 6 minus 5 x. We can draw the graph and see, we can compare then the average fitness. What we have, x can change from 0 to 1. Okay. So, let us draw for the large beetle first. When x is equal to 0, it means we do not have any other large beetle in the population, this is just the one, then the expected payoff is 10. Why? Because each time it interact with other beetle is definitely going to be a small beetle and it would capture all the resources. So, in that case 10. And if x is equal to 1, it means the whole population is made of large beetle. So, this beetle will always be interacting with the large beetle. In that case, we have already seen the payoff is 4. From here also we will get 6 multiplied by 1. So, 10 minus 6 is 4. So, let us say here is 4. And since it is a straight line, we just need 2 points to draw this line. And of course, this is for the large beetle. Okay. Now, let us do for the small beetle. When x is equal to 0, means the whole population is made of small beetle. So, small beetle would always interact with the small beetle and the payoff is going to be equal to 6, which is also clear if you put x is equal to 0, this will be equal to 6. So, this is 6. Of course, it is not to the scale, so do not worry, the only thing is that it is lower. And when x is equal to 1, in that case payoff is 1. So, this, and this is for small beetle. So, what do we see? That a large beetle always does better than small beetle. So, no matter how small proportion of large beetles are introduced in the population or they get introduced on their own, they would have better fitness on average. And so, over the time their population would increase and they would eventually wipe out the population of small beetle. So, starting with small beetle population, you will get the large beetle population. So, clearly small is not evolutionary stable, that is what we write, that not only for any x, for all x, the fitness of large beetle exceeds the fitness of a small beetle. Therefore, small is not an evolutionary stable strategy. Now, the next question is a very similar. Can we say that large is large an evolutionary stable strategy? What do we need to do? We cannot use this distribution that we are having here, 1 minus x and x. What we have to do? We have to start again and say that population is entirely made of, let us say, large beetles, and a small population of small beetles are introduced or they get introduced. Let us say in the new setup their proportion is x, and for the large proportion is 1 minus x. Now we have to do again in this new environment how a large beetle would do vis-a-vis a small beetle. So we have to calculate. Basically what is happening here? That a small population of small beetles invade the population of large beetles. So payoff would be very similar. Here we have 1 minus x, x. A large beetle would get, a large beetle would make, large would interact with other large 1 minus x proportion of times. So it's going to be how much? 4 multiplied by 1 minus x. And x proportion of time it would be interacting with the small beetle. So the payoff would be 10x. The sum is going to be 4 plus 6x. Similarly, expected payoff to small or expected fitness of a small is going to be 1 multiplied by 1 minus x, coming from here 1 multiplied by 1 minus x, and 6 multiplied by x. If we sum these two up, we will get 1 plus 5x. So, what do we get? In case of an invasion by a small beetle, the expected fitness of a large beetle is 4 plus 6x and expected fitness of a small beetle is 1 plus 5x. So, if we draw vis-a-vis x, x varies from 0 to 1. For the large beetle starting from 4, it goes up to 10, 4 to 10. And for the small beetle starting from 1, it goes to 6. This is for large beetle and this is for small beetle. Large beetle always has better fitness than the small beetle. So, small beetle would not be able to invade the population of large beetles. So, large is evolutionary stable. So, let us summarize what we have learned. That if a few large beetles get introduced into a population of small beetles, large beetles will do really well. Why? As they rarely meet each other and they get most of the food in most competition, because most of the competitions are happening with the small beetle. So, they do really well. And population of small, therefore, population of small beetles cannot drive out the large ones, so that small is not evolutionary stable. What happens if the converse is true? If a few small beetles get introduced in a population of large beetles, they do very badly. Why? Because most of the competition they will have with large beetles, and they will do worse than large beetles. So, a population of large beetles will be able to resist the invasion of small beetles. Therefore, large is evolutionary stable. If you pay attention to this particular game, let me draw it for you. 6, 6, 4, 4, 1, 10 and 10, 1. This is small, this is large, this is small, this is large. If you look at it, it is same as prisoner's dilemma. But notice we didn't use that logic. We cannot use this logic because beetles cannot rationally decide to become small or large. They cannot strategically decide. But if you just look at the payoffs, then it is same as prisoner's dilemma. Here S, L strictly dominates S. So, L, L is the only Nash equilibrium in this case, because both the players have, sorry, here I have by mistake written M, this is L. So, for player 2 also L strictly dominates S. So, we have in fact dominant strategy equilibrium, and which is of course a Nash equilibrium, but we cannot use the same logic. Now, if we pay attention to other fact, one more thing that we learn, that over the period fitness, average fitness is decreasing from 6 to 4. we begin with that average fitness is 6 and now the average fitness is 4. So that is also problematic, because what we have learned from evolutionary biology, that is not very important for game theory, but just to complete the chapter, we should say that natural fitness is not increasing over the time. So where did the Darwin go wrong, or where did we go wrong? The thing is, Darwin didn't go wrong, because Darwin talked about that natural selection increases fitness in fixed environment. Here the environment is not fixed. Environment itself is changing. Environment itself is becoming hostile for everyone. So which is naturally decreasing the fitness of the population. So it doesn't contradict the Darwin's theory. Okay, that's it. We will again come in the next module. We are going to compare evolutionary stable strategy with Nash equilibrium, and we would also check what happens in the case of hawk and dove game, which one is evolutionary stable. Thank you.